Hi, I'm following up this series with various players, and just from my own experiences being around them and talking to them for a number of years. And you know, I've done it in a way that I don't really betray confidences of the players. There are things that I know and I don't talk about, and this is really done in a way to encourage people to pray for the players, but also not to be afraid to go and believe that there can be help. There can be a way to reach them, to help them, and to be treating them as human beings who have real needs and not just people who hit a tennis ball over the net and are very good at it. So today I'd like to follow this up with the series I've been doing, which is the Williams. We have the mother and father. We have the cousins, the nieces and nephews, the sisters. And then we have Serena and Venus. And they've been really a joy to work with. When I first came on the tour, of course, in 2002, full-time, they were well-known. They were at the top of the game. And so as I would be around, they were kind of looked at in awe by the other players at that time. When they would walk in, everything would just kind of stop and players would look at them. Now, that's changed in the year 2010. They're not quite the way they were because other players have become number one and come and gone, and they're not playing as much. But at that time, they had a very special star quality about them. And, you know, all I could do was pray and introduce myself. I remember, I can't remember exactly how it first started, how I had relationships with them, but I do remember bits and pieces. I would go up and give the daily bread, which is put out by RBC Ministries, a short devotional that fits in your pocket, and I would offer that to Serena or Venus. And, you know, at that time, Serena would turn it over and look at the back because if it didn't have the Watchtower Society, which is Jehovah Witnesses, she would just wouldn't take it. And she would look at it, and she'd give it back, you know. And I understood that about what they believe, Jehovah Witnesses. They only believe material that they have in their hands. And the truth is that puts away all the Christian bookstores all over the world where material is available for people. Isn't that sad? All kinds of good, great material. And it just allows them to have a viewpoint of that one-sided viewpoint. However, having said that, you know, I understood the approach. And I think there were situations in the family where, you know, I understand that people, it's not always a model perfect family. So as you would just stay and pray and you'd watch and you'd be friendly to people, you'd be friendly to the family members. And Richard and his wife Ornice had just gone through a public divorce, and you know, that was sad to me. But at the same time, you know, there's always sides that you don't understand. You're just an outside observer, and there's always different sides to the story. And the kids were involved in that. You know, on one hand, the kids didn't know Serena and Venus, and the sisters didn't know how to handle that, who to go with, how they should be when they were with their mom, with their dad, how they should spend their time, how the family should travel together, whether mom would travel with by herself or dad. And that's kind of the way it worked out. And then over a period of about 6 or 7 years, things started to try to get started to become more stable. Richard and I struck up a friendship. I really don't remember how that happened, but I remember that over a period of time, I gave him a Bible. I spent a lot of time with him, hours and hours. I'd go to where he was staying, his housing, and he and I would talk. And, you know, he's a man who loved God. He told me about his growing up, his childhood, and we talk about all kinds of things as friends talk about. And, you know, I was very fortunate. One of the greatest blessings I had was he told me about how he raised his kids and what he did with them as far as tennis, how he was, it's never been made public, actually. And that was a real blessing to hear that. As a tennis coach, I learned a lot. And so, you know, every time I'd give him verses, and we'd talk about where his concerns were about his spiritual life. And, you know, I found out later that he was going to a Baptist church, he told me, and he had had a friend who was a pastor. And I don't know, all I could do there was to be there to support him from a Christian standpoint, a follower of Christ. And I continue to do that as I see him. I don't see him that often because I'm not traveling as much and he's not traveling as much. But that was the relationship. And then Venus, who is very close to her dad, as I would spend time there, she knew that I was friendly with her dad. And so I was able to give her material and talk to her. And this year in the 2010, she came to me and said, anytime you want to share Bible verses with me, I want to do that. I'm happy to do that with you and to sit down and talk about Bible verses. And that's a real step. And the other thing is you don't hear her talk about, you hear her talk about Christ and being blessed. And her approach to her faith is quite different, I feel, than Serena's. But again, they're a family. They're individuals too. And so each person in the family I had to treat just as an individual. And Venus would always treat me well, always smile at me, and knew very much what I was doing, and I think respected that. Serena, for me it was really just a matter of standing back and letting her work through life situations and being there as a friend and praying for her. You know, she's recently gone through a heart problem. So those are issues that I think scare people. Jehovah's Witnesses believe that you can never really know for sure if you have eternal salvation when you die. It's all based upon works, and there's no guarantee. And these were issues that came up as I would speak to the family, and I would share about how Christians know they have eternal life based upon the blood of Christ. And we would talk about that. And so I'm in the point where Serena watches me very carefully. She knows what I do with her family. She's seen the relationship grow with her family, myself and the family, over a number of years. And, you know, I just need to be there as she's working through these different situations in her life. Her mother, friendly, I can sit down with her mother. Her mother totally respects who I am and what I do, and she's told me that I really like that you're bringing God to the players. And she has daughters, and she has nieces and nephews, and I've been able to spend time with them. But again, I don't see them enough. It's not like a full-time friendship. But on the other hand, I'm able to sit down. I'm probably the only person who sits down with her on a regular basis at the tournament. Usually she's just by herself. Or maybe with her daughter, but I'm sitting with her, and she welcomes me to sit with her. So this is how the Williams, how I've been able to work with the Williams, and Richard's invited me down to Miami. If I'm ever down there, he said, stop by and visit me or stay with me, I think he even said. So, you know, these are real open doors, but I haven't been able to make it down there. And I've done my part over a 10-year period, and if you listen very carefully, you'll hear Venus talk about Jesus. She'll talk about blessings. You won't hear her mention Jehovah very often. I haven't heard it for years, actually. Serena, you still will hear. Richard, actually, I don't hear him mention that. I think he's kind of in the middle, but he's actually been wearing some hats that say something about God and church when he's on TV. And I think I encouraged him a lot in that area. I'm happy about that. And, you know, let's just continue to lift up the Williams in prayer. They impact a certain segment of our population that look up to them, people who are the Afro-Americans, people who are kind of in that situation where they don't want to follow the established routine to get to the top in the tennis world, but they want to choose their own way, which is how the Williams did. You know, there's a group of people that really look up to Serena and Venus and the whole family, and we just pray that God can use them and that in their lifetime they'll be used greatly by God to lead people into a relationship with Jesus Christ. And we just pray for that, and I just want to share that with you. And we'll open up another topic in the future. So stay tuned and come back to tennisministry.org.